You know, Surah Yusuf actually is very important in the life of the Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam. It is one of the surahs revealed in Makkah al-Mukarrama, and it is a time when the Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam has so much suffering, and people who are his opponent, they have got so much power. So the Quran has revealed this story to the Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam, the full story, complete story, because it was to tell the whole life of the Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam, that how he will pass the suffering and the, how the success will come. Usually the Quran picks the different part of the stories in other surahs, more than one story. This is the only surah where you have got only one story, complete story, because at that moment the Prophet ﷺ needed a, you know, something like that. What the story tells, you know, very clearly is that first thing is trust in the revelation of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. What Allah reveals to you, trust in that, whatever he promised. Yusuf alayhi salam and Yaqub alayhi salam both have been promised that difficulty will come to you, but at the end of the day you will be supported and helped by Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. They believe in that. Second thing, the surah makes very clear that when Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala wants to decide something and wants to help the believers, nobody can stop him, because he got qudrat. You know, that this surah basically makes a believer to have full trust in the revelation and the full trust in the power of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, that, you know, his power is full, he can do whatever he likes. And the next thing is, the believers, if they do two things, then Allah will help them. One is the taqwa, they fear Allah, they follow his command, and then be patient. Wait for Allah's command, it will happen. And now you can see the whole story basically moving in that direction. Yusuf alayhi salam, you know, obeys Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala's command, follows his command. He put in one difficulty in the well, then in the house of those people, and then in the prison. From one difficulty to other difficulty, never complains about this space, never complains that how difficult his life is, obeys his command of his Lord, and listens to him, and he knows that Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, when he commands something, he will do this. And then actually the time comes when you can see this, you know, the events are unfolded, and the time comes when Yusuf alayhi salam gets the success in this world, and Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala makes him the, you know, the most important powerful person in Egypt, and his own brothers, they come to him, and they basically come as the beggars. But you see again actually Allah's mercy. As Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala is merciful to Yusuf and Yaqub, and because they're so pious, he wants to help them. At the same time, when the help is coming to Yusuf and Yaqub, he also wants to give something for the brothers who did not listen to Allah properly. So he gives them chance. So he makes Yusuf alayhi salam to make the brothers to go and come back again, until the brothers, their hearts are broken and they regret what they have done, and their pride of their might and power is broken and shattered, and they become humble. Like when the humility comes to them and the power is broken, and they become nearer to the repentance, then Yusuf alayhi salam actually, you know, reveals everything, and then Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala forgives the brothers, and Yusuf alayhi salam actually also forgives them. That's a big lesson for the Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, that this will happen to you as well, that people will cause difficulty for you, problems for you, but you keep following the path of the taqwa and the sabr, and the time will come when you will enter into Makkah al-Mukarrama as a conqueror, and these people will be under your mercy. And when the Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam entered into Makkah al-Mukarrama as a conqueror, then leaders of Quraysh came, and the Prophet asked them, what do you expect from me? So they say, what a brother expect from a noble brother. So the Prophet said to them that I will say to you what Yusuf said to his own brother. You see, he's taking a lesson from Surah Yusuf. And then he said, then no blame upon you, he forgave them. So you can see, after all those things, Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala made the Prophet successful. But even as Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala made his mercy on the enemies and opponents of the Prophet, they also got chance to be forgiven. So those people who have been creating problem for him, Prophet ﷺ forgave him, and then they become believer, and the Prophet ﷺ gave them so many camels and this and that, until their iman became improved and they become good defenders of Islam. So the way of the Islam is basically the believers, they should follow the path of taqwa and sabr, and their enemies will create difficulty for them. If they remain, firm on the path of taqwa and sabr, the time will come when the believers will be the winners, and those who have been creating problems for them, they will be the loser. When they become the losers, then the believers are not allowed to take revenge. When the people who have been your enemy, they are defeated, then you must forgive them and must make a new chance for them to repent and to become like you. So this story basically, you can see the complete story and the best story, and in that actually, for everybody, there is something to get. For the believers and for the unbelievers, and the end of the day, basically Allah the mercy, it encompasses and covers all of the people.
So Surah Yusuf is
Prophet
very closely for the Surah Yusuf.
How is
it applicable for us living in the
Yeah, you know, it is that, you know, everything in the Quran really has come for guidance for until the day of Qiyamah. So basically, that's how the Quran is that, you know, whenever people pass in the same condition, they can apply in every individual and every community, they should follow the way of Yusuf al-Islam. That, you know, follow the command of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala and be firm, be patient. One day, you will get the success. That will happen. But people have to wait. If you lose the patience, you can't win. The way is, listen to your Lord, obey His command, follow His command, and be patient. Then Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala will help. But if people don't listen to Him, don't become nice, don't become pious, then Allah will help not come. Allah's help comes with taqwa and the sabr. And when Allah's help comes, then don't become in a mood of taking revenge. Always have forgiveness. You know, in our time, really, we Muslims have got so much hatred for everybody. Even before getting the power, we want to take revenge from the people. The way of Islam is when you get the power, still don't take revenge. Still you think how I can help other people. You know, bring the message of the mercy and love of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala to all the mankind. So no doubt there are so much great lessons in the Surah Yusuf as well. But I don't think I can teach the whole Surah now.